Okay, first thing we're gonna do is to init workspaces. Let me open the browser here. Alright, so workspaces documentation. So first, let's do npm init minus y. No, like this. So, and let's init a workspace as well. Same thing, minus y. So, and let's change some things here. So that should be named add ds workbench slash components, of course. So, alright. So let's do this within packages. So we can safely copy this over and call this component for now. Yep, seems to be good. Let's, is it already done? It is already done. That was fast. So then let's check the package JSON here. So let's copy this. Alright, now we can delete this folder and rename this one without replacements, like this. Alrighty, so then let's do this. No, not yet. So we go into the components folder and let's scaffold out the storybook. Yes, of course you should install this. Okay. White config changes, TypeScript config changes. Okay, we can do this in between. The white config, we should update it. So it's source my element. This is meant to be only one element, and at the moment it is not able to load those SVG files. No. Mm-hmm. Okay, let's try what happens. Yes, do it. Okay, let's see what we've got here. We have the stories here, and we have the button stories here. So this should be, why is there actually no, okay, that's not using any, it's not using a custom element right now. Let's see. What next? So this is storybook config changes. Probably I don't need it. So probably I should create an index.ts file here, exporting my components. So, and that's a component here. Oh, already. What kind of component is something we can achieve pretty quick? Let me check another library what they have. What is easy to achieve? Batch? No. Too much to be done. Text area? No, probably no. Input? Also too much. Button? No. Probably it's the badge. Let me check. Oh, there's no source code for it. Mm-hmm. Probably if we check it here. Yeah, there's the distributed. Probably I have to check on GitHub. Yeah. Let's check the source and the components folder. How does such a batch look like? Mm-hmm. Only a bit of HTML. Okay, that's not much. Okay, let's restructure this a little bit. Let's call the folder batch. Let's copy this inside of this. And probably we will need the story. All right. And let's rename that to DS batch. So and this should be, of course, DS batch stories, right? So then let's get rid of a couple of things here, for example this button. So example batch, we don't need these comments here. So archetype on click, we can leave this. Background color, we don't need it. All right, for now it will be any, and we need to get rid of first let's rename this. So that does a lot of things here. We don't want this. All we want to do is probably this for now. Shouldn't have too much. Let's remove this for now. Oh, they did that here. They have a batch styles file. Unfortunately, my plugin doesn't work anymore, where I can just click the imports here. So two folders up and styles, component styles. I want to check this up. How does this look like? No. Hey, come on. So styles, component styles. Okay, there are some defaults. Makes sense. Good. I don't like to define that here. For now, let's just have this. What's wrong with the imports? Lit logo. We don't need this. We don't need property for now. So this is all we need. And also no styles. We want to name the thing DS batch. Alright, so next thing we're gonna do is to import this DS batch here. So in component will be DS batch. And let's use this component. I'm not sure if I can do it like this. But let's see. So, and we want to output args.label here, of course. Remove this comp. So let's get rid of all of the rest here. So what's going on here? News default export. That does not matter. So CSS is not being used here. For now, I would like to create a folder called backup here, where I put in stuff that I probably need later on, just to double check. So the assets folder can be removed. No, let's do it different. Let's create a new file, call it git keep. Just that this folder is there, and delete this. Same for public. Let's copy this file. Yes, it's text. I don't care. Alrighty, so probably we should check how the whole thing behaves, right? So then let's go and let's run Storybook for the first time. Let's see what happens. So window opened here and we have an Houston, we have a problem. Component needs to be a string. What's the issue here? Okay, then without this component, who cares? Wrong window. This one, and my browser again. There we go. Now we got the batch in here. Again, wrong project. Let's close this. All right. So now that we got the batch here, what's next? So probably check if we can add some style. So therefore I copied the stuff here. That has no styles. Mm-hmm. Let me check one thing. I would like, well, let's create a new file called dsbatch.module.scss and let's create something here. So probably it should have border 1 pixel. solid gray for now. And the border radius. Let's make it 5. No, actually we could just get started with something that looks nicer. Makes sense. Where are the components? There are they. We have dispatch. Let's check on the style here. Where's the border radius? I can see it. There. SL border radius small. Where does it come from? Probably from this file, right? The variable definition. Interesting. Seems. Probably. Yep. Now we need to know radius small. Ram. Why not? So let's try what happens if we import the stats from of course, not form. From dsbatch module. So I guess it won't do anything because we don't have Sass installed. So let's see what we got here. Provided components needs to be a string, e.g. component. Yeah, I thought I fixed this. What's the point here? I don't know. Okay, so nothing. We got nothing. It's not even doing anything. Probably this thing is not even applied. So we can quickly find out. Of course it's not. So how do I apply this? So we are loading it here. Probably have to read on. Okay, we have to change something in our storybook. That looks quite similar, if you ask me. The only thing missing is the vite final. What does it do? Let's just try this. Let's reformat the code. So what happens if I do this? Nothing. Actually, nothing. So probably I missed something here. Yeah, that's probably the reason is that I should use this and export. Yes, batch from /batch DS batch. So let's see what happens if I restart. Nothing. So what's the issue here? Probably. Let's check. Let's call it dsbatch. Yes, render doesn't seem to be called. So how does this story look like? I believe they did that different. Okay, this is how it works. Interesting. And let's try this. No, it doesn't seem, that seems different. It seems like this approach here is using only the templating from lit.html, but not the web components. That's weird. How do I achieve this then? I believe it, I have to do it like this, but I need to check what else I need to get started with those components. Probably I will check here in the lit starter template. How does it work? npm run build. But would argue that I want to develop web components and not just use the templates. That's the test here. Okay. Then let's go ahead and check dev. There's an index.html file. Okay, no. That's not what I want to see here. So probably so it tells me that, let's double check if our documentation or configuration is really what it should be. So stories, so stories in the X, storybook web components. Probably I comment this for now and let's see what happens if I restart the storybook. We don't know yet. Probably not the expected behavior. So probably I have to Google this, use lit element in storybook. And let's use more up-to-date results. This is exactly the article I followed through. Let's check the repo. How is it done here? It is just the element. Ah, one could argue that I imported this file directly and this is not how it is supposed to look like. Then let's change this. So without this, oh, I see. That is the part that I was missing. So what I need to do is to do this here. So let's see what happens. Nothing. Import my element. Ah, of course. Okay. So then probably good, that's a good sign. Now it wants me to install Sass. I will do that as development dependencies, of course. Unsupported engine. Wait, let me check. I cannot read that this is unsupported greater than or equal to 1418. It seems that it runs, so I don't care. Now let's check again. So what we see here is a class name. What I want instead, is to render the CSS module to string. Let's make a more detailed search. Lit element CSS modules. All right, seems to be promising. Okay, those are the CSS modules, right? No, that's not what we want. Okay. Question is if that does work with Sass. Yeah, it does. But it's for Webpack, right? So, right. Load CSS module string. That's it. That's really it. I can't believe it. But all right, I will try it. Let's see what happens. Not bad. But now I have the class name. What happens actually if I do something like this? That's not working, right? It is Oh my god. Then I could also rename it. Doesn't have to be named like this, but instead like this. So, and the question is, how do I apply CSS now? Let me check. Where is the... I haven't copied over the my element. That's the here. Static styles, CSS. So that will be dollar styles, right? That has a problem. Mm-hmm. Argument of type string is not assignable to parameter of type number CSS result group. Is this true? Because I don't... Oh no, I see the error here. Server, internal server, a missing development specifier in lit package. Never heard of this. Let me find out what it is about. No, that's not my error. Is this really coming from this error? Probably not. And probably it has to be like this. No, that's not the issue. But what is the issue? Do we have a problem here? Probably I will just restart it and let's see if this happens. It happens. Unfortunately, missing development specifier in lit package. What the hell does that even mean? Let's search literally for it. No. Ah, I see. That's the reason why. So no, from here, of course. So we can close this. Was not something that helped. Still issues. I believe we should restart it. Alright, unsafe CSS. That's a security thing. Unsafe CSS. Where does it come from? So, can I just import this from here? No. So let's see what the fix is. Source lib CSS tag. Probably I search the lib element documentation for it. No, without the CSS modules. Unsafe CSS, of course, it is just a matter of the case. Alright, that works. So now we have CSS in place. Alrighty. Good, that works now. Probably a little bit of padding necessary. No, the opposite, like this. No, it was better the other way around. And it's already an unstyled batch. Wow. Like a batch with the minimum style, but that is what I wanted to achieve. So that means I can safely delete this here, and also we don't need the my element and the index CSS anymore. Alright. This is good to be started. So probably we should remove the primary, the onClick, onClick. No, I leave it like this for now. Okay. Nice. Done.